the time taken in the towing to minimize the time taken and to complete this project before the rig arrives in the new location and to avoid downtime to the engine, I have decided to do a pre-certification before the towing is commenced, and which we can save a lot of time to do a welding inside the column. And this is the pre-tap joint, and this picture here shows how we isolate the pipe inside the column, and the welding is in the process. And this is after we have changed the pipe, we have a new and more reliable seawater for water piping and piping line. And for this project, the cost of this project, the total cost for this project is $101,000 US, and the length that we have replaced is 41.2 meters for the seawater and 66.8 meters for the piping system. And the duration is 5 days for the prepare, and we totally completed this project in 7 days, which includes the dismantle of the scaffolding from inside the column. The third deficiencies that we have is that the sacrificial anode on the side shell of our pontoon has been depleted more than 90%, and this is the result from the UI survey done in 2008. And this table here is for the fourth pontoon, and this table is for the top of pontoon, which shows the same result, which the sacrificial anode is depleted more than 90%. So in transocean, we have two systems which is widely used as a cryotheric flotation system for our hull. Number one is the sacrificial anode, and the second one is ICCP system, which is impressed current cryotheric protection. So what is the difference between these two is that this sacrificial anode, basically we are connecting two dissimilometers together, and the less reactive metal, the more reactive metal will get corroded instead of the less reactive metal. And we will attach the less reactive metal to the hull, and instead of this hull get corroded, this sacrificial anode here will get corroded, so basically we're protecting the hull. So what happened in the ICCP system is that we impress an external source of direct current. Okay. And that current will be impressed on this hull. So that this is lead and silver anode, and it's considered inert. So what happened is that the potential of this lead silver anode will be same as the hull. So basically, none of them will get corroded in that environment. And between these two systems, we have chosen ICCP as our solutions. And why we choose ICCP is because it's more effective compared to the anode sacrificial system. In one single installation, it can cover the whole pontoon area, whereby the anode, we need to install about 84 amount of anodes to cover the whole pontoon side shell area. It's also cost effective compared to the anode system, and I show you the comparison here, which the anode, the initial cost of the anode is only 30K, but the duration to replace them all, which is about 84 of them, will take 28 days and cost us cost of revenue 5.4 million. And the ICCP system, the initial cost is double of the anode, which is 60K, but the duration for installation is half of the anode installation, and the loss of revenue from there is only 1.79 million. So we have a potential saving of 3.61 million from there. And as I said, it's also less time to install, and it's safer to execute this project because we don't need any diver to jump into the water. Mm-hmm. So in order to change this from the sacrificial anode to ICCP system, we need to have ABS approval, because this ICCP system involves a penetration to our watertight bulkhead inside the column. Mm-hmm. So this is letter from ABS giving us approval of doing this installation, whereby we send the engineering drawing.